おはようございます。
おはようございます。
WCCE2020 カメラです。どうですか、昨日は。
昨日はやっぱりちょっと大仕事が多すぎて疲れましたね。
どうですか、寝れました。
いやー、ぐっすりよあれだけやりきったらもう
今ちょうどね、ちょうどみんな集合でこうね集まってる。昨日はかなり大変でしたね。
いや、まさか教育長とお会いできるとは思っていません
ということで、教育長と昨日はお話をして、まさかね、
まさか
広島県の教育長と話すことになるとは。
いやしかも初日から
初日から。
いや、なんかオードリー・タンさんが簡単に見えてきました。
どうですか、ね、今日はあの台湾のね、はい、デジタル担当のオードリー・ターさんが、昨日は夜ね、頑張って質問をね、英語で作ったんですよね。
ちゃんと取ってもらえるように。
そうですね、今日も頑張っていきましょう。
頑張っていきましょう。
じゃあ中川君、意気込みをお願いします。
頑張ります。
ということで、WCCE2022 スタートします。
ということで、オードリー・ターンさんの講演を終えて、2年生の森本くんに今回の感想を聞いてみようかなと思うんですけど、はい、先ほどオードリー・ターンさんの講演を聞いてどう思われましたか？
そうですね、まあ正直あんまりよく理解はできなかったというか、まあ、難しい単語も多かったんであんまり理解はできなかったんですけど、まあ、ただなんかその質問に対してすごくなんかいろんな視点を持って答える人なんだなっていうのはまず一つ思って、それでいて、なんだろう、経験であったりその高校生に向け高校生がした質問がまあ2つぐらい入ってたんですけど、まあ、それに対してもなんか経験であったりすごく自分の信じる考え方みたいなものから答えをその語られていて、そこがすごく面白いなと思いました。
いや、完璧な感想を述べていただきましたけど、ありがとうございました。ということで、オードリー・ターンさんの講演を終えて、ということで、2人の生徒が来てもらったんですけど、じゃあ、まずは梶谷さんから聞きたいんですけど、先ほどの講演聞いてどうでしたか？
私自身、すごく正直な感想を言うと、すごく難しくて、あまり理解できていない部分が多いんですけど、やっぱりこういう貴重な機会っていうのは、本当にないようなものなので、すごく今日来れてよかったなっていうのが一番強いと思ってます。これからも何かそういう機会があったらやっぱりすごく積極的に参加もしていきたいなって思ってます。
ということで、続いて大阪のキャンパスの名前が
川端さん
ということで、先ほどの講演聞いていかがでしたか？
はい、私オードリーさんのことあまり詳しく知らなかったんですけど、すごく見た目から溢れる優しそうな感じで、最初すごくいい人そうだなって思ったのが第一印象なんですけど、話を聞いていくうちにすごい高エグザンポーって言ってたくさん の例がいっぱい出てきて、やっぱり普段から情報に触れておくっていうのが私たちにも大切なのかなと思って、本読んだりとかニュースちゃんと見たりとか、そういうことから自分の中に取り入れていこうかなって思いました。
いやー、2人とも完璧な感想ということで、ありがとうございました。
ありがとうございました。
ありがとうございました。
Okay.
Should be a short statement, right?
How did you think when Audrey Tang keynotes?
So yeah, it was a very impressive speech because I think she emphasized very important things like democracy in the digital world, and this is basically what we need today at most.
And you?
Yes, I think it was not a talk. It was a question and answer situation. The goal of her is okay, but I think it's a problem with the goal for many young people to be creative. I think she, and yesterday the keynote speaker, were both creative people, and if we are creative people, we think all people are creative, and I think it is not so. There are many people who are not intelligent and not creative. It's not the same, intelligent and creative, and so we have to recognize that we not overwhelmed people with the goal of creativity in a high form. And it is very hard to find situations how we can involve young people who are not so creative and intelligent. It's a harder job for a teacher, and it is very important for the future that all people can involve their perhaps little creativity, a little intelligence, but so the situation as teacher, it's hard. And therefore, I think she addressed more the upper people of the country, Taiwan or other countries the same. It was interesting, but I think there is a danger that we lose many young people if we only talk about creativity and so on, and overwhelm many of the young people.
Thank you. すいません。日本語で大丈夫ですか？
日本語ですか？
英語でもどうしようか。
May I say in English?
Thank you.
I like it very much because she actually emphasized the dialogue instead of just one way. You know, usually the keynote speech delivery is very one way, but it was very interactive, although the interactivity was limited to his audio and video and the text. But he was accepting of the question, and that was very democratic, I thought. And probably in the sense that they may cater to upper, because it would be very difficult for everybody to ask an intelligent question. And probably in that sense may discourage some of the people's participation. But I think just one way to deliver some dialogue and starting some dialogue, I thought his method was very, very good. And he emphasized the community building, democracy. I think that was really the theme we have to actually value. So I think his as a keynote speech, she did a very good job.
Thank you. Actually, they think about a question, social media and internet program についてまあ考えやついて
メディアクリエイター
Content creator, yes, right. Content creator. The way of the future.
You are a learner in media creation or you are a job as media creator?
Oh, thank you. ちょっと緊張してるので。
Well, I think it's a good opportunity for you to interact with the people from different countries. And at this early stage, it's a very rare opportunity in Japan because Japan is such a kind of island isolated in a sense country, and nowadays with pandemic you won't see a lot of the people from abroad, unfortunately.
So. Yes, okay, but it is not good that many people are attending to this conference only online. If, I think it will be a big danger for the conference in the future if that will be the normal situation. Many discussions in the evening, or I miss discussions in the evening because the people are not here. They are at home and are situated in the conference room online. I think it's not a good situation for the future if we have so much people online attended to a conference.
Well, actually, if we can accommodate both, that would be ideal. But, you know, the missing the social part, there are things we can communicate via online. It's very focused and very discussion-oriented, theme-oriented. But the human beings, human relationships are not that, only that. We talk, not just you know, serious matter, but the cultural thing, the music and the playing music and so forth. And that informal part is very, very important. And that's a make a relationship, you know, to make a relationship.
But coming back to this keynote, probably in 10 years this will be possible because we will be able to transfer our environments.
The 6G, sixth generation. Yeah. I hope that's gonna really happen. But even then, I think real face-to-face communication with the, you know, I don't think even 6G can actually mimic.
I think it must.
Mimic.
It must. Most of people must be on site. And if there are a few people who are not on site, and not is okay. But I think about more than 50% are online, and you see here, most people are here from Japan, it's okay, it's nearby, but the international connections are missing in such a situation.
Yeah. Okay, thank you.
Hello.
Okay, your speech will be delivered.
Thank you for the interview.